There's a phrase that's been used for more than half a century that many people do not fully understand. So for today's lesson, we're going to talk about what it means when an album or a song has chart success. While a number of different music publications have their own lists that calculate a variety of different factors, in most cases, the charts refer to the top 100 singles or top 200 albums that have been tabulated by Billboard Magazine since the 1940s. In the early days of the charts, the singles were separated into categories for radio airplay, jukebox sales, and overall retail success, but in the 1950s, they were all merged into the single category, the Hot 100. There are a number of other more specific charts within the Billboard rankings, but it's the 100 and 200 that stand as the most prestigious for an artist. Until the 1990s, the radio data that was used to calculate this was actually submitted by hand by radio DJs across the country. This, of course, skewed things quite significantly, as a song had to have been commercially released for it to make it onto these charts. It also had a lot to do with what songs or what artists the labels were pushing, so one can argue that at various times it may not have been the most accurate representation of what was being listened to. In 1991, Billboard began to use the SoundScan technology to track radio airplay, and this not only led to greater accuracy, but it also showed just how quickly a song could plummet as soon as the label stopped pushing it. In the late 1990s, another significant adjustment was made to the calculation algorithm, as it was no longer necessary for a label to have officially released a song for it to chart, and this led to a lot of deep cuts and B-sides making it onto the top 100, and in a lot of ways allowed the listeners to dictate exactly which were the best songs on an album. Of course, in 2005, paid digital downloads were added into the mix, and suddenly songs that had little to absolutely no radio airplay were blockbuster hits. Over the decades, the Billboard charts have allowed people to see trends and unthinkable achievements occur in the music industry, most notably the run of Pink Floyd's Dark Side of the Moon's absolutely unthinkable stay on the album's charts. For 15 years, it stayed without leaving the charts in the top 200, and the only reason it fell off of the charts was because of a change in how the sales were measured. 2 years later, when they reverted to the old system, Dark Side of the Moon jumped right back into the charts. While in recent years, many people argue that the Billboard rankings don't nearly have the stature or prestige that they once did, there's no question that for more than half a century, the Billboard charts stood as one of the most vital barometers of the state of popular music and culture in general.